In 2011, as Libya's skies filled with the chaos of civil war, a different kind of observer hovered above. It was not a manned aircraft, nor a regular UAV, but a state-of-the-art vertical takeoff unmanned aerial vehicle. Deployed by the US Navy, this autonomous helicopter, engineered by Northrop Grumman, was on a reconnaissance mission, far from the front lines and unknown to those below. That is, until chaos caught up with it. Mistaken for a lethal Apache gunship, a rocket-propelled grenade struck down the fire scout, its remnants landing 85 miles east of Tripoli. Libyan State TV immediately broadcast images of the wreckage, claiming a rebel Apache was destroyed. However, analysis of the debris soon told a different story. The distinct markings and unique shape revealed its true identity, an MQ-8 Fire Scout drone helicopter. Rumors swiftly spread about its mission, potential armament, and more importantly, the power it would wield from Africa to the far reaches of Afghanistan as the US's new rotary wing UAV. The US Navy utilizes UAVs for various roles, marking a significant step in modernizing naval capabilities with autonomous systems. These UAVs support maritime surveillance, target identification, mine detection, targeted strikes, electronic warfare, and cargo transport. In the mid-2000s, the Navy started replacing the aging AAI RQ-2 Pioneers, first introduced in the 1980s, and developed jointly with Israel from the Mastiff UAV design. Originally deployed for real-time reconnaissance to assist naval gunfire, the Pioneer's role expanded to broader surveillance tasks. Despite its success and critical role during the Persian Gulf War, the rapidly aging Pioneer led the Navy to seek a more advanced second-generation UAV to enhance future operational capabilities. The US Navy called for an aircraft system that could perform vertical takeoff and landing, or VTOL, with a payload capacity of around 200 pounds. For adequate naval operations, a minimum range of 125 miles was required, alongside a service ceiling close to 20,000 feet and an endurance on station of 3 to 4 hours. Coupled with its VTOL capability, the new UAV had to be able to land on a Navy ship under winds of 29 miles per hour. The vehicle was designated as a VTOL UAV, and several companies immediately submitted their proposals, including the likes of iconic aircraft companies like Sikorsky, Bell, and Schweitzer Aircraft. Ultimately, it was Schweitzer's design that captivated the American Navy. Their concept was based on the company's Model 330, a three-passenger commercial light utility helicopter with a length of 31 feet, a height of 11 feet, and an overall weight of 2,400 pounds. It was dubbed the RQ-8A Fire Scout, and it would sport a modified fuselage to house the UAV sensors and electronics the Navy required, as well as a new fuel engine to fulfill the range and loitering points highlighted for operations at sea. The first flight of the RQ-8 Fire Scout, sporting a Rolls-Royce 250 C-20 turbine engine, employing JP-8 jet fuel, took place months later with great success, leading Northrop Grumman to become the primary contractor for the vehicle, supplying data link functions based on the RQ-4 Global Hawk UAV to control it. The control system was planned to have a range of up to 172 miles over a line of sight and could be installed on a ship or carried on a Humvee light vehicle for use by the US Marines. Other features that would enhance the Fire Scout's performance included a sensor ball turret equipped with infrared and electro-optic cameras, as well as a laser rangefinder. Despite the potential of the VTOL UAV, the United States Navy concluded that the Fire Scout did not live up to its expectations and canceled the funding for the project in 2001. In whatever case, Grumman and Schweitzer continued the development of the Fire Scout as a private venture between both companies, attracting the attention of the US Army. A contract for the development of 7 upgraded RQ-8B was awarded to test the vehicles for use with ground troops. When the first prototype debuted, it was redesignated MQ-8B Fire Scout. The MQ-8B was distinguished by its 4-blade main rotor system, a departure from the RQ-8A's larger 3-blade configuration, designed to enhance lift capabilities and performance while minimizing noise. This 4-blade design increased the gross takeoff weight to 3,150 pounds, accommodating payloads of up to 700 pounds for military missions over short ranges. With dimensions of 23 feet in length, 6 feet in width, and 9 feet in height, the MQ-8B combined a compact design with a large payload capacity. For use with the Army, the stub wings of the Fire Scout served a dual purpose. First, it provided the helicopter with better aerodynamic characteristics and armament allocation, which included Viper Strike laser-guided bombs, laser-guided 70mm folding fin rockets, Hellfire missiles, and pods equipped with the APKWS, or Advanced Precision Kill Weapon System, which was a conversion of Hydra 70 unguided rockets with a laser guidance kit that essentially turned them into precision-guided munitions. Besides the standard sensor configuration, The Army requested additional configurations, leading Grumman to come up with other packages, some of which included a multispectral sensor, the Signals Intelligence or SIGINT module, a Target Acquisition Minefield Detection System or ASTMIDS, and the Tactical Common Data Link or TCDL. Testing of the new MQ-8B Fire Scout began in 2006 at Grumman's Moss Point, Mississippi production plant. Following the first successful flight in December, the U.S. Navy's interest in the platform rose again, leading to the introduction of the Sea Scout. Ironically enough, shortly after the Navy's adoption of the program, the U.S. Army dropped out of it and decided to continue employing its line of RQ-7 Shadow UAVs. The U.S. Navy officially adopted the Fire Scout in 2009. The final design of the UAV looked like a modern helicopter, except it was fully autonomous. The fuselage and nose carried all the electronic optic suites, with several full-color cameras placed around the aircraft to provide a perfect view from all sides. Sea Scouts were fitted with the Navy's baseline camera package, a maritime radar system, a communications relay kit, and a mine detector system. The shielded compartment housed a UCARS antenna array and the Tactical Common Data Link antenna array. Flight control actuators and fuel stores were allocated in the mass superstructure, while the aft of the fuselage housed a boom assembly that ran a shaft powering the tail rotor. The tail featured a vertical fin extending both above and below the end of the boom, with two horizontal tail planes attached to the top of the fin. The Rolls-Royce 250 C-20 engine, pushing 420 horsepower, gave the helicopter its maximum speed of 132 miles per hour, a service ceiling of 20,000 feet, and an operational range of 930 miles. Like other UAVs, the Fire Scout could be operated autonomously through programming. This meant it could take off, fly, and land automatically. Furthermore, the Fire Scout's mission parameters could be updated on the go without the need for it to land. In May 2011, the Navy deployed three MQ-8s to northern Afghanistan to conduct intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance operations. The next deployment of the Fire Scouts came in 2012 aboard the Oliver Hazard Perry-class frigate USS Clackring. The helicopter served the U.S. Africa Command, conducting anti-piracy operations off the coasts of Africa. The unit of Fire Scouts maintained 12-hour days on station, with one of the drones setting a record after providing 24 hours of support through the course of 10 flights. The MQ-8B helicopters achieved a significant milestone in August 2013. Over 28 months, the Fire Scouts participated in crucial surveillance missions for American and Allied forces, accumulating over 5,000 hours of flight time. During six at-sea deployments, the Fire Scout surpassed 10,000 flight hours in total while supporting naval and ground forces. In April 2010, the Fire Scout made its first official drug bust. It was dark, and no stars were on the horizon when USS McInerney launched its newest asset against smuggling. The Fire Scout took to the skies for what was one of many routine test flights. But peace soon shifted to action. Within minutes, an operator detected a small, fast-moving boat on the radar, a possible suspect of drug smuggling. What began as a simple data-gathering exercise became the Fire Scout's first real test in drug interdiction. The drone chopper trailed the suspect boat across the vast ocean. For over 3 hours, the Fire Scout shadowed the unconfirmed vessel until it rendezvoused with a larger fishing boat suspected of being part of the smuggling operation. Back on USS McInerney, the crew prepared for detention and combat. The ship assumed a strategic position while other personnel prepped smaller boats for interception. Coast Guardsmen geared up, while the drone gave them visual data about the unidentified personnel on board. The footage from the drone allowed the boarding team to carry out the mission successfully, submitting the drug traffickers swiftly and without issues. Regarding the triumph, Paul Young, commanding officer of the McInerney, expressed in an interview, quote, "We'd interdicted numerous trafficking efforts already during the deployment, so these parallel efforts flowed smoothly, but there was a little extra anticipation associated with this operation, knowing Fire Scout was on task as well." In early 2011, the U.S. Air Force deployed Predator and Global Hawk drones over Libya, since the ruthless civil war between rebels and pro-government forces broke out. As part of Operation Unified Protector, the U.S. Navy did the same, deploying several Fire Scouts operated by USS Halliburton. Although it was not clear how many Fire Scouts were operating off the coasts of Africa, chopper drones were deployed to perform intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance operations over Libya to monitor pro-Gaddafi forces. On June 21, 2011, the Navy announced it had lost contact with the rotorcraft while it was conducting these operations over the clear skies of Libya. During the course of the day, Libyan State TV announced to the nation that government forces had taken down an Apache gunship. Although the local press was fooled, military and intelligence agencies worldwide knew it was not the case. The debris from the crash site revealed the destroyed rotorcraft was indeed a U.S. Navy fire scout. It was never revealed if the U.S. Navy continued deploying more fire scouts for the remainder of the civil war in Libya. While the fire scout achieved its milestones overseas, Grumman announced it would begin testing a four-bladed, single-engine Bell 407 helicopter modified with the autonomous capabilities of the smaller MQ-8B. The Bell Model 407 is a civil utility helicopter based on the Bell Model 206. It features a composite hub originally developed for the United States Army's OH-58D Kiowa Warrior helicopter employed during the Vietnam War. Also dubbed the Fire X, the second variant was formally introduced as the MQ-8C Fire Scout, and it flew for the first time in 2013. This variant had a payload capacity of 2,950 pounds, a length of 34 feet, and a height of 10 feet. The Fire X was powered by a single Rolls-Royce 250 C-47B engine, providing 813 horsepower and enabling the helicopter to reach a maximum speed of 160 miles per hour, an endurance of 15 hours, and a service ceiling of 20,000 feet. Following the first flight in 2013, the U.S. Navy awarded Grumman a $262 million contract to produce the aircraft before finally introducing it to service in June 2019. As of January 2023, the United States Navy has procured over 40 Fire X's, with more on the way. While the second variant of the Fire Scout has succeeded as the Navy's next-gen helicopter, the original Scout has been retired from service. The reason behind this is simple. The Fire X significantly doubled the range and endurance of the previous Fire Scout while tripling the payload capacity. As time progresses, the duties of the Fire X will increase with the U.S. Navy, bolstering the drone with lethal ordnance and more sophisticated sensors.